Hi, myself Rajalakshmi Esrai from Vidyalakshmi First Aid College, Savanur. Now I am taking second year BCom Business Taxation. We already solved 3-4 problems relating to the incidence of tax. Now we can solve the problems of question bank 2007. So this question appeared for the year 2007. So as usual, the first column should be ordinarily resident. Second one is not ordinarily resident. The last column is non-resident. Non-resident. Then you can see the first transaction. Salary received in UK. So salary received in UK. Salary received in UK for service rendered in India. It is important, service in India, that is income due in India. So three columns, yes, the amount is given 1,10,000. So we have to write yes, yes, yes. We have to write in three columns 1,10,000, because even though it is salary of UK, but it is service in India, that means amount is due in India. So three columns, yes. The second one is salary in UK, same, salary in UK, then for services rendered in UK. So if the service or the income is due in also in UK, in foreign country. So here foreign salary and received in the for the service also foreign, so due in foreign, received in foreign. So first column yes, then all columns dash dash. So it is amount is 4 lakh. So it is foreign income because it is due in foreign UK and also the service is also in UK. Next, agricultural income in UK. So agricultural income in UK. Next question, 50% is remitted to India. I already told you, brought to India, remitted to India, deposited India, leave it. It is just for confusion they are giving like that one sentence. Remitted to India, deposited in India, brought to India. There is no difference in that sentence. So we need only this much. What is that? Agricultural income in UK. So agricultural income in India, one second, dash, dash, dash. But it is agricultural income in foreign country. So first is taxable. So the amount is 1 lakh. So write in first column 1 lakh. Then put in all column dash dash. Next, profit from purchase and sale of standing crop. So purchase and sale of standing crop. Standing crop in India. So remember always, if it is agricultural income, then it is dash dash dash. When it is the purchase and sale of standing crops, for example, instead of selling sugar cane, we are selling the sugar cane in the field itself. Not after cutting. If it is cutting, then we are selling the sugar cane, then it will become agricultural income. If it is in standing, in the field itself we are selling, then it is called as standing crop. So it is buying and selling, it is treated as business. So ಒಂದು ಯಾವುದು ಭತ್ತವನ್ನು ಸೇಲ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು, ಭತ್ತವನ್ನು ಇರುವಂತ ಬೆಳೆಸಿದಂತ ಗದ್ದೆಗಳನ್ನು ಸೇಲ್ ಮಾಡೋದಕ್ಕೂ ಡಿಫ್ರೆನ್ಸ್ ಇದೆ. ಭತ್ತವನ್ನು ಸೇಲ್ ಮಾಡುವಾಗ ಅಗ್ರಿಕಲ್ಚರ್ ಇನ್ಕಮ್ ಆಗ್ತದೆ, ಅದೇ ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಕ್ರಾಪ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಗದ್ದೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಇರುವಾಗ ಅದನ್ನು ನಾವು ಸೇಲ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ಅದು ಬೈಯಿಂಗ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಸೆಲ್ಲಿಂಗ್ ಆಗಿ ಅದು ಬಿಸ್ನೆಸ್ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಗ್ತದೆ. ಸೊ ದೆನ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಅಗ್ರಿಕಲ್ಚರ್ ಇನ್ಕಮ್. ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಆರ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಟ್ರೀಟೆಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಬಿಸ್ನೆಸ್ ಇನ್ಕಮ್. ಸೊ ಹಿಯರ್ ದಿಸ್ ವರ್ಡ್ ಈಸ್ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್. ಇಫ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಸೆಲ್ಲಿಂಗ್ ಎನಿ ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಕ್ರಾಪ್, ದೆನ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಟ್ರೀಟೆಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಎ ಕಮರ್ಷಿಯಲ್ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಇಟ್ ಶುಡ್ ಬಿ ಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಹ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ತ್ರೀ, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಓಆರ್, ಎನ್ಒಆರ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಎನ್ಆರ್. ಸೊ ಹಿಯರ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಈಸ್ 20,000. ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ 20,000 ಈಸ್ ಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸೇಬಲ್. ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಸರಿಯಾಗಿ ನೋಡಬೇಕು, ಖಾಲಿ ಅಗ್ರಿಕಲ್ಚರ್ ಇನ್ಕಮ್ ಆದರೆ ಮಾತ್ರ ಅದು ಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸ್ ಫ್ರೀ. ಎಲ್ಲಿಯಾದರೂ ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಕ್ರಾಪ್ ಅಂತ ವರ್ಡ್ ಬಂದ ಕೂಡಲೇ ಅದನ್ನು ಕಮರ್ಷಿಯಲ್ ಅಂತ ಟ್ರೀಟ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಮೂರಕ್ಕೂ ಅದನ್ನು ಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸೇಬಲ್ ಆಗಿ ಹಾಕಬೇಕು. Next one is business income in UK. So business income in UK, next transaction. Then controlled from India. So the word is there, controlled from India. Then it is given in the bracket, one third received in India. One third received in India. So bracket close, the amount is given 1,20,000. See here, three transactions are combined here. So business income in UK, that is foreign income. Controlled in India means controlled setup once again. Means two column, yes, yes. ಈ ವರ್ಡ್ ಬಂದ್ರೆ ಕಂಟ್ರೋಲ್ಡ್ ಮತ್ತೆ ಸೆಟ್ಅಪ್ ಇನ್ ಇಂಡಿಯಾ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಟೂ ಕಾಲಮ್ ಎಸ್ ಎಸ್ ಬರ್ತದೆ. ಬಟ್ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಬ್ರಾಕೆಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಗಿವನ್ ಒನ್ ಥರ್ಡ್ ರಿಸೀವ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ಇಂಡಿಯಾ. ರಿಸೀವ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ಇಂಡಿಯಾ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ತ್ರೀ ಕಾಲಮ್ಸ್ ಎಸ್ ಎಸ್ ಎಸ್. ಸೊ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಗಿವ್ ದ ಪ್ರಿಫರೆನ್ಸ್ ಟು ಆಲ್ ಕಾಲಮ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ಹಿಯರ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಂಟ್ರೋಲ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ಇಂಡಿಯಾ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ರೈಟ್ ಇನ್ ಟೂ ಕಾಲಮ್ಸ್, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ 1,20,000, 1,20,000. ಬಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಗಿವನ್ ಒನ್ ಥರ್ಡ್ ಈಸ್ ರಿಸೀವ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ಇಂಡಿಯಾ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ ಕಾಲಮ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಟೇಕ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ one third, that is 40,000. Understood? If the word controlled is not there means, see here difference, if the word controlled is not there, listed is given business income in UK, one third received in India, if it is given, then in first column we have to write 1,20,000, then second column it is received in India, so 40,000, then last column 40,000. Now I think you are clear about the adjustment. So one third received in India means last column is blank. So we have to take one third here. So next we can see the next adjustment. Can see the next transaction. It is given business income in Chennai, that is in India, controlled from Hong Kong. Controlled from Hong Kong. Then it within bracket it is given one third received in Hong Kong. One third received in Hong Kong. So in the outer column it is given 1,00,000. So no doubt, first sentence it is enough. Business income in Chennai means it is Indian income. So income received or derived from India or due from India, that means four, three columns, yes, yes, yes. No need of seeing the other transaction, whether it is received in foreign country, whether it is remitted to foreign country. No. First sentence is enough. ಈಗಿರುವಾಗ ನೋಡಿ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಸೆಂಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಸಾಕು. ಬಿಸಿನೆಸ್ ಎಲ್ಲಿ ಡ್ಯೂ ಆಗಿದೆ, ಎಲ್ಲಿಂದ ನಮ್ಗೆ ಇನ್ಕಮ್ ಬಂದಿದೆ ಅಂತ ಗೊತ್ತಾದ್ರೆ ಆಯ್ತು. ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ವರ್ಡೇ ಉಂಟು ಬಿಸಿನೆಸ್ ಇನ್ ಚೆನ್ನೈ ಅಂತ. ಅದೇ ಏನು ನೋಡ್ಬೇಕು ಅಂತಿಲ್ಲ, ಕಣ್ಣು ಮುಚ್ಚಿ ಮೂರು ಕಾಲಮ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಅದೇ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಅನ್ನು ಹಾಕಿದ್ರೆ 1,00,000, 1,00,000. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಸೀ ದ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸಾಕ್ಷನ್. ಡಿವಿಡೆಂಡ್ ಫ್ರಾಮ್ ಬ್ರಿಟಿಷ್ ಕಂಪನಿ. ಸೊ ಡಿವಿಡೆಂಡ್ ಫ್ರಾಮ್ ಬ್ರಿಟಿಷ್ ಕಂಪನಿ, ಬ್ರಿಟಿಷ್ ಕಂಪನಿ ಇನ್ ಯುಕೆ. ಸೊ ಡಿವಿಡೆಂಡ್ ಫ್ರಾಮ್ ಫಾರಿನ್ ಕಂಪನಿ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಆಲ್ವೇಸ್ ಫಾರಿನ್ ಇನ್ಕಮ್ ಒನ್ ಕಾಲಮ್ ಎಸ್, ದೆನ್ ಆಲ್ ದ ಕಾಲಮ್ಸ್ ಡ್ಯಾಶ್ ಡ್ಯಾಶ್. ಯಾವುದೇ ಆಗಲಿ, ಡಿವಿಡೆಂಡ್ ಆಗಲಿ ಇಂಟ್ರೆಸ್ಟ್ ಆಗಲಿ, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ರಿಲೇಟೆಡ್ ಟು ದ ಫಾರಿನ್, ದೆನ್ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಕಾಲಮ್ ಇಸ್ ಎಸ್, ದೆನ್ ಟೂ ಕಾಲಮ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಡ್ಯಾಶ್ ಡ್ಯಾಶ್. ಬಟ್ ರಿಮೆಂಬರ್, ಇಫ್ ದ ಡಿವಿಡೆಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಂಡಿಯನ್ ಕಂಪನಿ ದೆನ್ ತ್ರೀ ಕಾಲಮ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಡ್ಯಾಶ್ ಡ್ಯಾಶ್. ಸೊ ನಿಮಗೆ ನೆನಪಾಗಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಗೊತ್ತಾಗಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಪ್ರತಿಯೊಂದು ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಅನ್ನು ಬೇರೆ ಬೇರೆ ಟೈಪಲ್ಲಿ ಹೇಳ್ತಾ ಹೋಗ್ತೇನೆ. ಎಷ್ಟು ನೀವು ಕೇಳ್ತಾ ಹೋಗ್ತೀರಾ ಅಷ್ಟು ನನಗೆ ನೆನಪಲ್ಲಿ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಉಳಿಯುತ್ತದೆ. ಸೊ ಡಿವಿಡೆಂಡ್ ಫ್ರಾಮ್ ಬ್ರಿಟಿಷ್ ಕಂಪನಿ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಒನ್ ಕಾಲಮ್ ಈಸ್ ಎಸ್, ದ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಈಸ್ 80,000. ಸೊ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ರೈಟ್ ಇನ್ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಕಾಲಮ್ 80,000, ದೆನ್ ಟೂ ಕಾಲಮ್ಸ್ ಡ್ಯಾಶ್ ಡ್ಯಾಶ್. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್, ಇನ್ಕಮ್ ಫ್ರಾಮ್ ಹೌಸ್ ಪ್ರಾಪರ್ಟಿ ಇನ್ ಲಂಡನ್. So income from house property in London. Next, it is only given like that only. Income from house property in London rupees 35,000. So it is clear house property in and London means it is foreign income. So the amount is London 35,000. So first column only 35,000. Next two columns dash dash because it is the foreign income. Next we can see the next one. Next one is income from deposit with SBI. So income from SBI means no need of seeing other transaction. SBI means it is Indian bank. Indian bank, deposit means interest. Interest in Indian bank. whatever may be the brand. Bank is India. So three columns. Yes, yes, yes. So it is given. See once again. Income from deposit with SBI, comma London branch. Whatever may be the branch, but bank is in India. The income is due in India. So three columns. Yes, yes, yes. So branch yavudu untu, bank yavudu untu antalla namge yava bank alli bandide, Indian bank alli bandide. So three column. Yes, yes, yes. Next one is interest on deposit with Bombay branch. So deposit is in India. It is in Bombay branch. So same case. So it is related to the Indian bank. So Indian income. Then Bombay branch of foreign bank. Whatever may be the bank branch, but bank it is due in Bombay. That is in India. So three columns. Yes, yes, yes. Amount is 65,000. 65,000. 65,000. So three columns. Yes, yes, yes. Next one is past untaxed profit brought into India in the previous year. So I have already explained that the word past untaxed means it is tax free. It is related to the previous year. It is related to the previous year. Past means previous year. So past untaxed profit brought into India in the previous year. So it is always not taxable. So put dash 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 in three columns. The last transaction is gift from a friend. Gift from friend in UK received in India. It is 54,000. So whatever may be the case, we have to see the gift received from who. It is from the friend. So the rules is, if it is in excess of 50,000, fully taxable. I already told about this one gift. If it is related, if it is given by the relatives or family members, then it is whatever may be the amount, fully tax-free. But the gift is given by any friend or outsider, then up to 50,000. If it is 50,000, it is free. If it is 50,001 rupee, then full amount is taxable. So here it is given 54,000. So it is in excess of. We have to write it within bracket. We have to write when answering the question. You should write within bracket in excess of 50,000. Then you should write the full amount. Don't deduct 54,000 minus 50,000. We have to tax the full amount 54,000 in three columns. Yes, over then total the columns. So in the first column we get a total 11,14,000. First column total is 11,14,000. Second column is 4,99,000. 4,99,000. Last column is 4,19,000. The last column is 4,90,000. So over. Thank you.